May the odds be ever in your favor. Hey YouTube, can we talk about underage gladiatorial combat? Of course I'm talking about The Hunger Games, one of the best young adult novels. Actually, one of the best novels, period, that has come out in the last few years. I've recommended these books to a lot of my friends, and every single one of them have loved it. If somehow you don't know what The Hunger Games is, let me fill you in. The Hunger Games is a novel set in a post-apocalyptic future where the evil capital rules the 12 districts that used to be North America with an iron fist. As a reminder of the capital's power, kids from each of the districts are forced to compete in a gladiatorial death match that is televised on live TV and is mandatory viewing for everyone. Pretty messed up. Katniss Everdeen is selected as a competitor or tribute in the Hunger Games. Spoiler alert, and the rest is history. Yeah, that's right, I have a Mockingjay on my shirt. The first book and its sequel, Catching Fire, explore the ideas of rebellion and control in some amazing and riveting ways. But chances are you know all of this already. The Hunger Games series has been a monumental success. I think this is interesting because they're sort of the anti-Twilight. In fact, both stories share a lot of conventions but come out with entirely different results. Both The Hunger Games and Twilight have teen females narrating in the first person present tense. Both stories give their protagonists two strong male love interests, one who is obviously right for her and one who... I'm not gonna ask if you're Team PETA or Team Gale because I'm sure you're gonna let me know in the comments. Whoever she ends up with, I think she wins. And whoever Bella ends up with, I think everybody loses. The wonder of The Hunger Games is, no matter how surreal or radical the conceits of the story are, they are rendered so beautifully and incredibly realistically and believably. Katniss is this great, strong, female role model who I can respect even when she makes mistakes or false judgments. Maybe especially then. Normally I don't have crushes on fictional characters, obviously a complete lie, but Katniss is pretty awesome. The final book in the trilogy, Mockingjay, comes out in just a few days, and I cannot wait. I've already got a spot for it in my bookshelf. Those of you who follow me on Twitter know that I've been working on some songs about The Hunger Games. Those songs will be released August 24th. In the meantime, here's a preview of one of the songs called Reaping Day.
Wake up late, it's reaping day.